All right, so very quickly, this is just an informal session, and I'm just going to invite them to say something about what I call 50 plus 50. 50 years of the past of Singapore architecture and 50 years of the future. You can choose any 50 you like, all right? So I'm going to just set some context here, again, as a kind of good remembrance of the works of Singapore architects of the past 50 years. So to start off with 1970s, of course, none other than the Golden Mile Complex, DP Architects. So that was a time of nation building and bold experiment and newfound confidence. So that was the 70s, but in the context of that oil crisis, right? In 1980s, again, there were other crises, and of course, the rise of postmodernism. Issue of climate begin to come in. We start to talk about tropical architecture, and again, asking question, is there a Singaporean identity? And in 1990s, we start to see a boom, commercial forces very much at work, and property boom. Those of you who bought property then, you remember, right? Or old enough to remember. So that was 1990s. And 2000s, we start to see, again, housing boom, the rise of, in a way, the Singapore architecture very firmly established in the housing market. I remember those days, Woha's work, Su Kien's work, all starting to rise. Again, Mankok, your work as well, at that time, starting to come out very strongly. And 2010s, we start to see new identity, new housing form, Duxton. Unfortunately, we can't have Bing Bing here tonight, but next time we'll have him. So moving on. So where we are today, 2020, just before 2020, I think if those of you remember all the SIA award projects, 2010, 2020, there were so many good works. And of course, I have to pick a work of our SIA president here to show that we are really breaking a lot of new grounds. Human centricity, transformation all come in the picture. Just when we think that we could go very far, we are hit by COVID crisis, right? And the whole image of construction sector changes. Now, I just want to go back one step very quickly. I was SIA president after my dear friend Rita here, 4, 5, 6. Then I was doing 7 and 8. And then Ashwin after me, 9 and 10. And after that, Theodore, 11, 12. Oh, okay, yeah, 3 years. I'm the only one who did 2 years. You did 3 years too. So again, that cohesiveness is very important. Succession of presidents, leadership, council, all together. I think we managed to push through quite a lot of things.
Started sowing the seeds. No, just, I started the idea of sowing the seeds, yes. Yeah. Hi, everybody. Yeah, I'm forced to say something. Now, I think what Lee Siang has mentioned is that we all need to work together collectively. I think that's very important. It's not one person's task. I think the idea of setting the blueprint, the vision, and that now, after 15 years, Melvin, you're carrying on the good work that was also given by our Chi Huang and even Richard Lai. So there are a lot of aspiration that comes from the team itself. So I hope that this can carry on by the younger generations. Have a good evening.
By the way, Rita obviously was the first lady president of SIA. All right? And what a shame to SIA. Where is the next one? So you got a big task there. So, okay. Now, 2022, where we are today, obviously is interesting. I think optimistically we are coming out of COVID, learning to live with COVID. So it is a very interesting pivoting time. And I really like to know your thoughts, right, gentlemen here. We have environmental targets to peak emissions at 2030, and then we're trying to be carbon neutral by 2050. What does that look like to the community of architects, both from institutions, from industry practitioners, and the students? So this is where I want to hear your views. Okay? I'm not going to say anything, but all of you are invited to say something. We start with the three gentlemen here, and then if anyone wants to chime in with a thought, please. Let me start with Renee.
thank you, Lee Siang. I think this is a terrific evening for architecture in Singapore. And I'm glad that this is happening because I think this doesn't happen enough. It's either someone giving a two-hour lecture or a 45-minute lecture on their works, but not things like this. So I think this is, I hope this will be the start to a few more sessions like this. Now, Lee Siang said that we could talk on the last 50 years or the coming 50 years. So I guess I can start off by saying that I'm a PR here. So it's fascinating for me to see the growth of Singapore in the last, 50 years. At 58, I have not seen everything, but I think I've seen enough to be able to share some views. And when I saw what Lee Siang emailed us, asking us if we'd be comfortable to say a few things, I said, oh, yeah, sure. I think I grew up for better or for years under the knowledge that Singapore had done very well.
Architects moving forward need to embrace that we are the integrators of technology, of funding, of being able to put all the stakes together to create a piece of architecture. And architecture no longer is just about that building. It really is about the systems, the people, and all that. So I think that integrator role, an architect, is where we need to... I mean, we are integrators. Yesterday, we had Minister Desmond Lee with SIA. I had a chance to just speak a little bit about what architects do. And I think one of the things I said was that we possess the ability to integrate at all levels. We as architects have the ability to see and understand the various aspects of everything. And I thought that would be where we will be placed in the future.
Time change, different learning method. But the principle in architecture, I wish it remain the same, and even more so, we should be consolidated, from the school, SUTD or NUS, okay? That is what I'm going to do as a president of Board of Architects. And I find that SUTD take a different lead in the training of architects, architecture students, in the digital solutions before you come to architecture. And I find the SUTD graduate come out is that they have quick solution. They are good in digital solution. If the boss asks them to change the facade, computation, beam, pop, how many you want? 20, 30 solution, all come out, right? So right on that strength, okay, that the training you have, other opportunity will be more enticing and they find that they can achieve their goal much faster than stay on. So this is a great challenge that I have to work on, and also I think similarly to SIA, this is a similar challenge. I'm with SIA for many, many years. We're working together for many things. So this is something that we really want to find ways to solve. But I think the SUTD have done a great job to train up many students from a different angle of approach to architecture. That's all I want to say. Thank you.